I'm Dan Ragland. My title is Senior Principal Engineer. We're here in Intel's Overclocking Lab in Hillsboro, Oregon. The Overclocking team at Intel, our role is to create capabilities, knobs, configurability to allow our customers to push our silicon to the absolute max.
I'm assigned Intel. I've been working for a number of years.
ASRock collaborate with Intel since from 2002.
We have been partnered with Intel for over 30 years now.
Intel and Gigabyte's partnership has continued for over three decades.
Our role in enabling potentially the world records they achieve would be to make sure that they have access to these tuning knobs. If there's anything missing, we would want to get that added. That's really our job, enable them to reach those higher heights.
We got a lot of OC buttons, and we got some like heater features, because for the extreme overclockers, you're doing like liquid nitrogen, right? It's about like minus 198 degrees. So when they get a heater like underneath the CPU, it can help the CPU can, like the memory controller can be more normal and can operate like more stable.
We have some new features. One is the nitro path DRAM technology. So this is actually a very special slot design that's on your motherboards on our ROG series. It has shorter gold finger pins, and it actually allows a better communication between your DRAMs and your CPU, and it is there to minimize the distance the signals must travel and reduce some potential errors. So with that feature, that you actually can have a better performance for your overclocking.
The OC neural OC engine that is unique. And unique AI model that is trained by Gigabyte with a biodiverse data set that combines lots of CPU and memory settings or values. With that, you are able to provide an AI pre-trained model for users to overclock their system with ease without an optimized performance directly. With that, we're combining both AI-driven, but also with the legacy, what the process of overclocking itself, into a very innovative of the progress of the overclocking.
For our Unify X motherboard, that's geared towards our heavy overclockers. And for this generation, we have also added a new, what we call an extreme PC tuning solution. So it's kind of like a little small box that you can overclock your memory profile, your CPU clockage, with just a simple press of a button. And that's going to help make a lot of users maybe start stepping into the overclocking world.
For folks who are in the overclocking community and they're thinking about Arrow Lake, there is so much to explore. The memory controller has been completely redesigned from the ground up. And what's exciting about this memory controller is its maximum frequency headroom has been extended. So you're actually going to see higher highs. You'll be impressed with some of the world records that are set with this memory controller. A lot of new industry firsts are going to be enabled by this.
For the overclockers, we have a high cookie, our overclocker. We have opportunity to co-work with him. And we have used our overclock focused motherboards, which is called the ZA90 Taekyeon. We have at least to break the memory performance to over 9466 MTS for the memory.
Our overclocker is going to be top C. So he's going to be doing all of the LN2 overclocking with our MEG Z890 Unify X motherboard.
GPU Pi and also some Cinebench records. Yeah, I think possible to be there. And also for sure, the memory speed. And we're going to use the Z890 Taiji Oshi formula. And for sure, we will use the liquid nitrogens. Yeah, and the best, the cherry pick CPU. And for sure, we've been a lot internally. Yeah, so try to get the best scores.
We're going to set all of our settings to break some world records. We're going to do Cinebench at 6.5 gigahertz.
Actually, for a Hero and Extreme, they can go up to 8800s. And for the Z890 Apex, that is our motherboards for overclockers, and it can achieve over 9000 megahertz.
These are foundational changes that will affect the future of overclocking. It's a really fun thing to explore and try now. But for the average everyday overclocker, you've got higher memory frequencies, you've got that usual ratio frequency control that we've had in the past. along with some expanded options like the 16 megahertz ratio increments. So this is a great one to explore. A lot of change has occurred, a lot of new opportunities created. What I really like about this is today's overclocking world record may become the future's standard overclocking capability, standard in-spec capability. It just gives us that insight into what the future is going to look like, and the future is bright for DDR5 speeds.